What is up, everybody? It's Joe from JLW Games coming at you with another cool video back in Planet Coaster and the one, the only time sitting in. I am back, of course, in the sci-fi section working on the Flying Coaster Queue Line / Station. And as you can see here, we're working a little bit on the cover for the Priority Pass queue, which we got these long switchbacks, these big long switchbacks here at the beginning of the queue line. That's kind of going to be our focus today, is try and get a lot of scenery and theming through this entire area. So just... hold on tight, because here we go. Interestingly enough, there's not much that we actually get done in this episode, I would say. Again, except for like the scenery and theming, we do some cool effects, kind of some more triggers to the actual ride itself. So that's kind of cool, and get a little bit of lighting in there and a little bit of fun scenery and theming that's gonna go through in this episode. So we do actually start to enclose this first part of the queue line, which is nice because it needed to be enclosed and everything like that. So just so you guys are aware, I am starting up work as of today, so I will be hopefully not really lighten up at all on videos or live streams or anything like that. Hopefully I'm trying to figure a way out to where I could still live stream just as much. I can upload videos just as much. I've been uploading every day, actually, for probably close to a month, if not over a month by now. And hopefully I can keep that streak up for quite some time. I got quite a few videos kind of planned already. I try to plan a little bit of advance of what I'm going to be posting in the future. And as of right now, it's going very, very well. And hopefully I can keep it up. Even on days where I'm kind of busy, like today, I got up even earlier just for you guys to try and get this video out early, just in case my stuff that I have to do today went later. But as for live streaming, I don't know when I'm going to live stream tonight. Probably when I get done and get home from all of my stuff at work. So, as you all know, I work at Silver Harvest City, and today's actually my orientation, so I get to do all that. I don't know if we're going to do any training stuff or if it's going to be a completely all-day thing. It usually is, but I will have to remain known for that. So again, a lot of different stuff going into this final switchback section. All these TVs are gonna have a custom video made and everything. I need to start keeping track of how many custom things or what custom things are going in, because I gotta make a list for when I do upload the park eventually. You guys need to have access to those custom files so you can get the full park experience. That way you're not missing out on any of the custom audios, the custom videos, and anything like that. So being the sci-fi / futuristic section, we're allowed to have lots of TVs and a lot of different things like that. So I'm excited. You're gonna see a lot of this wiring on walls and a lot of different equipment, because the idea of this part of the ride, you're actually inside of a giant, almost like a giant spaceship or something, and you're launching out into space, kind of like with a jetpack. So that's why you're in the flying position. So that's kind of the effects of that we're kind of going for throughout this area for this ride. So anyways, looking pretty good. I like all the wiring that I did. There's a lot of pausing because there was a lot of stuff going on, interaction with you guys in the chat and everything on the live stream. So that's kind of like the mini pauses that I have, and I was getting a little bit excited because we were starting to get some subs and a lot of support in the chat and everything like that. So I just want to say I appreciate you guys so much. If you do join me on the live streams, I appreciate all of you guys, and I always take the time to appreciate you guys. That's why I stop in the middle of the live streams and the recordings, because of those moments like that. And It's just a lot of overwhelming support, and I really enjoy it because we just hit over 30 subscribers on Twitch, which is awesome. And when I say subscribers, it means something different on Twitch than it does in YouTube. YouTube subscribers are like followers, and then on Twitch, you have followers and subscribers. Subscribers on Twitch actually pay for your to support your channel. So if you're on Twitch, a subscriber actually pays for that, and I actually get a little bit of that revenue, not all of it, but because Twitch takes the rest of it. But it still supports the channel, and I appreciate it a lot. So if you guys want to, be sure to check out the Twitch channel. Go follow me, go do whatever you want to, and if you want to watch these episodes live, like real time, while you can talk to me in chat, be sure to do that. We're getting such a great community. I love talking to you guys almost like pretty much live in person in Twitch. So it's a great lot of fun stuff going on there, to where you can watch these episodes live and more. There's also, I do more than just these episodes. I do a lot more. I play all sorts of different games as well on Twitch, so you can watch me live. So the details are starting to come together in the queue line. It's coming together with a lot of different scenery and theming. I'm trying to get the walls very populated, and the roof is going to have a starry kind of effect, almost like it has windows on the top of the roof. And that was the idea that I was going for on that, which you will see here shortly, that I attempt to do that. But first, a little bit of the station work. I thought these little helmet racks would look good for like the the storage bins, and that's kind of what I wanted to go for. So a little bit of theming here in the station, and it's looking quite beautiful, and I hope you guys think so as well. It's one of my favorite rides that I've been working on lately, and I hope you guys are enjoying it as well. It's been really, really cool. I love being able to do some sci-fi stuff and a lot of modern kind of deals, and you can see that the lighting in this ride is going to be epic, with lots of, you know, bright pinks and light blues and stuff like that, and even a dispatch lighting effect that I'm gonna do, kind of like Salvaged, but it's gonna alternate between the pink and blue light while it goes out, almost like a warning lights while you're launching out into space. That's kind of the idea, that you're launching out into space, then you're gonna take the tunnel that's gonna take you up into deep into space, and we're going to be testing out our jetpacks pretty much and everything for the ride. And I do the same some lighting also right as you exit, that way you can always see the alternating lights as it goes along, as you're leaving the station. So anyways, that is looking quite fine, and I did a lot of back and forth triggers between these two lights on both ends, and I have to say the result is pretty awesome. And the light tunnel is actually one of my favorites as of right now. And so I'd love to hear what you guys think so far of the effects and the different stuff going in to this ride as of right now. It's going to be a heavily themed ride. I have a lot more lighting that I want to do outside, on the outside portion of the ride as well, to give it a really cool light package at night. I think it's going to look really neat, really awesome. You guys love this coaster so far, and so do I. So I hope we continue that trend as far as we can go up. So we have another TV there, and another video that's going to be playing in that spot, kind of giving instructions about the ride or something along those lines. And these lights right here are going to be kind of a cool addition as well, just giving a little, again, more of that spaceship kind of theme, that there's a lot going on here. And just look at the background of all those supports and everything. It's just absolutely incredible. I think it's just kind of amazing of how all that looks. But also, if you guys want to have lots of discussions with me or other fellow viewers about Planco or just in general theme parks and roller coasters, be sure to join the Discord down below in the description. Come join the Discord and be part of the community. We have a lot of stuff we're doing. We have over 70 people in the Discord, which is awesome, and we're always looking to get some more. We're always trying to improve the Discord, making it awesome, so be sure to join the Discord for us and just have a lot of fun. It's just basically fun, you know. All we do is discuss stuff, and it's a lot of fun out there. So anyways, I hope you guys go and do that. Join the Twitch as well. All the links in the description, guys, for all that stuff. I know I say it every single episode, but really, guys, I'm not joking. It's a lot of fun. And if you guys want to get further and be a part of this community a little bit more, you know, go join those stuff. Go join Twitch and go join Discord. And I believe this is actually episode 60, if I'm correct. And I'm very excited that we got all the way up to 60 episodes going strong. This is by far the longest running series that I have had on the channel, so that's kind of exciting. So 60 episode, I guess you'd call it anniversary, which is kind of fun. Anyways, we're getting some cool lighting, of course, inside this. It's meant to be kind of darkish in the queue line, so that will be kind of interesting. Everyone wanted an overview of the park, so I gave it to them, and I had to do that little pan over of the park there for everyone to see what's exactly is going on in the park as of right now. So anyways, the building's turning out cool, and I'm hoping to finish it up within the next few episodes so we can get the exterior done, all the interior done, and we can get this coaster done and move on to like the dark ride and stuff. So I still got to do custom audios tracks for stuff like this coaster and also the Roman coaster. I still have custom audio for that. But that sometimes comes later on, so we'll figure that out quite sometime later. So I didn't want to keep the same plain roof in this part, so I decided to go and do a little bit of a starry roof that's also going to have a roof planted on it with windows, so you can actually see through the windows to make it look like we're looking up into space in the ship itself. So that's going to be kind of the idea of this room. You know, it's a long switchbacks, and I'm trying to make it themed as possible, as much theming as I can with what I can, because all I have, you know, to my advantage is the roof and the walls to theme up, you know, because it's nothing but switchbacks in the middle. So you got to take advantage of that. So I tried to make my own kind of opening to see what I could do, and it wasn't really working out at first, so I just kind of decided to try and find it. And I ended up going with one of the shop front pieces, which actually turned out a lot better than anything else that I could have used, I think, and it turned out quite nice. And we had that with a combination of a couple lights as well, which I ended up finding the piece. It took me a while to find it, but I was like, wait a minute, there are some shop front pieces that are not wall pieces, that are not attached to the grid, you know? And I ended up finding this piece right here, recolored it a little bit, and then just rotated it for each section. And we ended up getting this as a cool result, and it turned out quite nice. And as for the game actually helped us a little bit of making it work out, because it actually was straight when I selected them all. Yay, 3D gizmo tool actually working sometimes. But I wanted to do this, and then of course it was a little bit weird for me, so I decided to go in and do a little bit of accents by adding some cool lights and everything like that to kind of go with it, and that kind of ended up turning out pretty good. So as you can see, like, the openings of the are going to be look like you're staring into space, and I like the result of how it kind of looks. I think it turned out quite nice. I think this place will look really good during nighttime, and that's kind of the look I always want. I wish I could do a time machine for areas, but that's just not the case. I mean, you have to be on ride. But anyways, as you can see, the lighting accents it kind of perfectly, and there's a little other spots open as well. And I also wanted to do a couple of space panels over here for the a couple of different openings as well on the wall. That way it's not as naked either, so that had some space as well. But anyways, we should be closing up this ride here pretty soon. Well, I mean, more like opening it up. But because we have a lot to do in the dark ride, which you all are aware of the dark ride that's going to be going in. That's going to be taking up a lot of time, probably a lot of episodes, probably way more episodes than this ever will. Thankfully, we've already gotten a good start on it, and at least the queue line's already starting to get themed over there. So that's kind of a good thing. And over here we have more stuff that we're working on as well. So anyways, this is about all we do in this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed. Make sure you comment, like, and subscribe for more amazing content like this. We post videos pretty much every single day right now, and we're live streaming almost every single day. So I hope you guys enjoyed. And again, links down in the description if you want to join the Discord, go follow me on Twitch, everything like that, links down in the description. And I hope you guys have a great day and even cooler tomorrow, and I'll catch you guys next time. Thanks so much, guys. Thanks, and goodbye.